You've come across a dog foaming at the mouth. It growls and snarls at you as it inches closer. It jumps and sinks its teeth into your leg. Uh-oh, the dog has rabies. What do you do now? This is Your Body on Rabies. You've been bitten by a rabid animal, and now you're infected. What will this virus do to you? And how much time do you have? According to the World Health Organization, rabies kills up to 59,000 people every year. Rabid dog bites and scratches cause 99% of those cases, but you can catch it from all sorts of critters. Cats, coyotes, skunks, and bats, among others. You've been bitten or scratched. You may not even know it. Your wound is tingling as the virus enters your body through the broken skin and infects your nerve cells. From here, it can travel to its primary destination, the brain. If you get vaccinated right away, you'll be fine. You'll have a series of 5 shots over 2 weeks, but you'll be in no danger from the virus. There have been no known failures of the vaccine. However, for this experiment, we're going to assume that you don't even know you're infected and you don't get vaccinated. The incubation period could take anywhere from 3 to 14 weeks. In this time, the virus has spread to your brain. How long it takes to get there will depend on how close your bite or scratch was to your head. As soon as the virus reaches the brain, it multiplies rapidly and will travel back through your nerves to most parts of your body. When the symptoms finally surface, you feel tired and suffer from headaches, fever, sore throat, and a lack of appetite. You might think you have the flu, and then comes the abdominal pain, diarrhea, and nausea. And that's just the beginning. The virus is attacking your central nervous system and causing inflammation in your brain. You have trouble sleeping and suffer from delirium. You're irritable and extremely worried about everything. And you've begun to hallucinate. The virus has reached your salivary glands and you're foaming at the mouth. If you've been infected with the furious form of rabies, you become hyperactive and excitable. You're anxious and confused and may attack others, trying to bite them. You have hydrophobia, an uncontrollable and irrational fear of water. If, like in 30% of cases, you've contracted the paralytic form of rabies, you start to lose control of your muscles. You are gradually becoming paralyzed. Eventually, you fall into a coma. Once the signs of rabies begin to show, there are no treatments that can help you. You will die. Rabies has a mortality rate of 99.9%, the highest of any disease on Earth. This will typically take 2 to 10 days. If you've made it past this point without any signs of rabies after being bitten or scratched by a rabid animal, does that mean you're safe? I'm afraid not. Even if you think you're okay, rabies symptoms can take as long as 7 years to develop in some rare cases. Rabies can also infect farmers or veterinarians working with rabid cows, scientists working with the virus, or anyone breathing air that carries high concentrations of the virus, such as in a bat cave. To prevent contracting rabies, get a vaccination before traveling to a high-risk country or if you're working closely with animals. Also, have pets vaccinated to protect them. And if you do get bitten or scratched by an animal, get immediate medical attention. Even if you don't believe the animal was rabid, after all, it's better to be safe than sorry. Now, if you survived that bite, let's find out what would happen if you did fall into a coma. Well, we'll see what effect that has on us in another episode of Your Body On.